Welcome back to Better Than Yourself. Today I'm Better Than Yourself, fermented applesauce. I was just visiting with my cousins out in Chicago, and she was telling me about making, she just had a baby, and the baby's like 6 months, 7 months old, and she's making fermented applesauce for her baby, and I was like, that's awesome. I eat applesauce all the time. I love applesauce. Why am I not eating that myself? So I talked to her a little bit about it and figured out her recipe, and I want to share it with you guys because it's super simple to make and it's totally nutritious and a great way to get a lot of probiotics into your system. A great way to, you know, a lot of people don't like to eat apples, don't like to eat fruits on their diet because they're so full of fructose. But how can you resist just, you know, having a delicious apple and then just, you know, something nice that you can just spoon up and have for lunch or have over your granola in the morning. So, but enough of that. Let's make some applesauce. We'll culture it and then we'll save it up into some little jars where it'll ferment, and then we'll have our fermented applesauce just to grab and go for a snack or throw one in your lunch or whatever you want. So what I want to do is basically just process these apples. These are Honeycrisp apples, quite sizable Honeycrisp apples that my wife and I have been enjoying. And but we're going to cut them up, peel them, and run them through the food processor, culture them with... You can use what you want. You can use, I know a lot of people like to buy use the little pills, use the little probiotic caplets, and we can stir that in. You can buy a vegetable or fruit culture that you can use to, you know, add probiotics to your, whatever you're fermenting and kick your ferment off with that. If you watch my fermented apples video, you saw I didn't even use anything. I literally just cut the apples up and put them under some salt water. So it's really up to you how you want to swing this. What I want to do with this one actually is we're going to grind these up into applesauce, and then I pulled a couple of ferments. I've got some fermented little corn wheels that I made. This is just a brine with some corn in it that's been fermenting for a couple of weeks. You could use some sauerkraut. Use some homemade sauerkraut that has a little bit of brine in it. You can pour a little bit of this off. We don't need much. We're not going to, you know, make a sauerkraut flavored applesauce, which might be good actually, but no, we're gonna culture the applesauce, and then I'm gonna use these Weck jars. These are really cool. These are European make, and it's literally a canning jar that is all glass and a piece of a natural rubber that fits between the two pieces of glass, and then uses these little metal clips to hold the lid in place. And then if you've ever canned anything, you know that basically you put this on, you would fill this with food and put it in boiling water for something this size, probably 5 or 10 minutes. And then the little airspace would be vacated from the heat and the air can get out from underneath this little lid. But as it cools, it sucks the whole thing down and cans it in there. And they're wet canning jars. I'll put a link for them below. You can pick some up on Amazon. But I got these for the holidays and I thought I'd press them into use. But I think what I like about them is I'm gonna ferment in them because I'm gonna put my applesauce in, let it bubble, and then they'll literally self-burp themselves, because as you can see, it doesn't take much for the pressure just to relieve itself out of this jar. So I'll let these ferment for, I don't know, about a week, I guess, until they get good and sour. And then, I don't know, leave them in the pantry and let them get really sour, if you're into that kind of thing. Or just stick them in the fridge after, 5 days, 7 days. And then you can, you know, grab these for lunch and take them to work with you. So these are gonna be awesome. But here, let's have a look at what we're gonna do here. So basically, I've got a couple of apples that I washed. I've actually got some applesauce that I made. Don't try to do this with commercial applesauce. Same problem we always run into. Everything you buy in the store has got preservatives in it. And the preservatives kill bacteria. Bacteria, probiotics, same thing. So the bacteria is gonna get killed by the preservatives in the commercial food, so you gotta make your own. This was some apples that I had, and I just canned up a bunch of applesauce, but I think I'm gonna ferment this jar just for fun, just to see how it comes out. To do our applesauce, get some apples, get your food processor. If you want, use your Vitamix, use your blender, something like that. And just literally sauce the apples. It doesn't take much to make applesauce. I'm gonna use a little melon baller, which is how I like to do my apples, just to get the core out and then get the little blossom end out. And then it's just a matter of running them through the food processor. But I just like this melon baller. It's a super quick way to get through a couple of apples. I don't know, people tell me that I'm supposed to be peeling my apples because they're covered with pesticides and all kinds of nasty things. So I guess it doesn't take that much longer to peel them. A chef that where I went to cooking school always said, you know, cooking is a matter of processing. It's a matter of seeing how much time you want to spend refining the food and making it that much nicer. So, you know, I can leave the peel on, but I think let's make a real nice refined applesauce. Take the peels off, get the cores out, get the seeds out, get the stems out, and we really, you know, just go for the best of the food. Find the best food you can and then improve it. That's your job when you're working in the kitchen, is to make food better. These corporations that process our food are just looking to make money, so they're not looking to make the food better, they're looking to make money. So make your own food. Take your time and spend some time with your food. Get good food and make it better. If you see any big chunks floating around in there that just aren't getting down, that's what the pulse button's for. Let it settle and then hit it. And that'll kind of get those big chunks on a funny angle and you can break them up. You don't have to let it run all day. But I think we're done. Yeah, this looks great. Nice. Look at that. I bet you always thought applesauce was brown. No, that's oxidized apples. That's apples that have been in a factory getting processed. Make your own applesauce. Look how gorgeous this is. This is nice. This is just pureed apples. That's all we're doing here. From here, like I said, I want to culture this with something. If you're afraid of the coleslaw, or if you're afraid of the sauerkraut, here, just 2 ounces. Stir that in, get that mixed in with all the apples. Do a little spices if you want to. I don't know, I've got some dried orange peel. Do something traditional, some cinnamon. Let's make some different flavors. I'm gonna mix mine in the jar. So let's get, so we've got our pureed apples that we've put a little bit of our, just our probiotic culture in. I didn't boil anything. I didn't sterilize anything. They're clean. They're out of the dishwasher. They're clean enough. And we'll do a cinnamon one. So we've got, our cinnamon in there. We've got our probiotics in there. Just give this a little stir in. And then put our weck jar back together. And there's just these little stainless steel clips. So here, these will just go in the fermenting room, my laundry room, and I'll let these sit for about a week. Here, get that cinnamon in there. Here, that'll work. All right, let's do another one. Let's do our orange peel, dried orange peel. I'm thinking about maybe doing a little bit of eighth of a teaspoon. I'm not using a lot, just a little taste. And these are like the perfect portion size. I really like these little jars she got. Kind of fit that all together and then clip it on. Nice. You can add some salt to these if you want that little insurance policy. We always put, you know, our brine in our ferments. Add a little bit of salt to these. You know, salt isn't ever going to hurt anything. Not so much salt that it tastes salty, but just, you know, it really, salt opens up the flavors. It really lets you taste flavors better. Here, I guess we'll just make a plain one. With the remainder here. But how easy is this? So you don't have to use my fancy jars. Use just a big quart jar. And put all your apple puree in just a big mayonnaise jar. Or any kind of a sealed container that you can put away for a week or so. And then have some fermented applesauce here. Actually, that worked out perfect. Couldn't have planned that any better. We'll put our jar back together. And like I said, I'll put these away for about a week and taste one and see how, and basically, I mean, they're probiotic as they are. I put probiotic brine in there from my fermented corn, but what you want to do when you're making these probiotics, when you're trying to make probiotic foods, not necessarily fermented foods, but probiotic foods, is you want those good bacteria, that lactic acid bacteria, to reproduce and to ferment a little bit of the sugar out and replace it with lactic acid and make a nice acid food that will preserve itself, but also give you those probiotics for your system, for your gut, for your digestion, and you'll have something delicious here. So here, fermented applesauce. Take care, you guys. Thanks for watching the video.